Okay. Cool, I think I'm live on everything.
Yay!
Just gotta wait for 3 o'clock. So, yeah.
Yay!
We did it. I can't whistle very well. Okay, it's 3 o'clock.
Yay!
Okay. Hello, hello, everybody. It's promptly 3 o'clock on this beautiful Sunday. Thank you for taking time out of your day to join me. Another note, if you can hear things outside, it's just too beautiful to have the windows closed, so I'm going to leave them open. So you may hear cars go by, but it's fine. Don't worry about it. Like I said, it's just too gorgeous outside. It's cold, or like cooler for the first time in what feels like forever. And there's very low humidity, so I'm, like, thriving in my fall mood, I guess. Also, hence my shirt. I'm just gonna go ahead and get started and play some tunes for y'all. So this first one, it's a Larkin Poe song. Now, you probably heard me talk on and on about them. I love them. Two pieces. They're, like, my number one favorite band. And this is off of their 2020 record. The record's called Self-Made Man, but this is a song called Ex-Con that I really love. And I haven't played it in a while, so we're going to start with this one. It's Larkin Poe's Ex-Con.
Well, don't talk crooked, honey, walk the straight and narrow. My mama tried to teach me the rules. She said, if Jesus himself keeps his eye upon the sparrow, then surely he is watching it too. 29 years young, I rode the hills half thicker, but I got to kicking the ground. I was a mover and a shaker, I mean I'm breaking, now it's all coming back around. Tell her it's a hard living, broke down on the highway, burned out an ashtray. Down to the bottom, it's a hard living. Singing hallelujah, man, tradition, it's kind of living. When I was torn, I was tracked like a rabbit, thought the name of the crime was getting caught. Now that I'm dressed in stripes, me and all my bad habits, I got the time to give it some thought. Living in the past has been a full-time occupation, I got a thing for talking to ghosts. Never moving on can take an awful lot of patience, and I'm the girl who's had the most. Tell me it's a hard living, broke down on the highway, burned out in the ashtray. Here's a bottle, right down to the bottom, it's a hard living. Singing hallelujah, may I introduce your next company. I'm Robert Reed and a high-speed chase. The late-night TV news anchors loved my face. Served my time and now the time is good for me to get back in my mama's good grace. And tell you it's a hard living, broke down on the highway, burned out in an ashtray. Hard living, and empty as a bottle, right down to the bottom, it's a hard
keeping on. So, this next song is an original of mine. This one's called Secrets.
I took a leap of faith and dove headfirst into your eyes. I really thought you were in I couldn't love. But then you turned around and told me that you didn't love me. Turns out I wasn't part of your plan. Turns out you left me out entirely. And I won't be falling for your eyes again. Cause it turns out we all have our secrets. Pretend to love me. Well, you can rest assured that you will never see me again. I'm cutting all ties, burning bridges with you. There's nothing that you could say to try and fix this. Cause it turns out I wasn't part of your plan. Turns out you left me out entirely. Well, I won't be falling for your lies again. Cause it turns out we all will have our secrets. Stop wondering what I did. There's no use in losing more sleep over you. Cause it turns out you weren't part of my plan. And turns out I left you out entirely. And I won't be falling for your lies again. Cause it turns out we all will have our secrets. Cause it turns out we all will have our secrets.
And a little note about that song, I was originally going to play that at my school's talent show, and I wrote this whole third verse, and then coronavirus happened, and school has been out since March. But, guys, I'm getting back on track. I just survived my first week of college at Sinclair, so, like, yay me, I did it. I didn't have that much work, but, you know, it's just, it's those little things when you haven't been in school for a while. You know, those little things kind of make a difference. Okay, so we're going to keep on rolling. This next song has a very special place in my heart. Growing up, my dad played us the Bangles all the time, and that was just something that was normal for us. On the weekends, we get in the car, we go to Target, because we're those people, and on the drive over, we would listen to the Bangles, and Erasure, and Thompson Twins, and the Pointer Sisters, and all these amazing 80s kind of alternative bands that are just so, so good. So this is a Bangles song, which is funny, because I love this song, most of their fans love this song, and they kind of hate this song because of the recording process, and yes, I did learn that on VH1's Behind the Music with them. Off YouTube, because I'm one of those people. But anyway, if you came here to hear the epic, like, whistle part of this song, please don't raise your expectations that high. I cannot whistle, so we will not be having that today, but I will play you this song. If you haven't guessed already, this is the Bangles' Walk Like an Egyptian. Cigarette, contact, and open up my side.
walk like an Egyptian.
Me sweat. Probably you didn't want to know that, but you know what? We're going to say it anyway. It's the internet. Anyway, I am going to move on to another Larkin Poe song. I know, big surprise there. You already heard me say that I love them so much. Favorite band. They were going to come to Hamilton, which is like an hour from where I live, in August this year, and then it got canceled because COVID-19. But I understand why they have to, because, you know, like, the greater health of humanity is really important, as opposed to, like, me wanting to go to a concert. But still, you know, I can be sad about it and still understand that what I'm doing is a good thing. Oh, that's loud. Hello. So I'm going to do another one of their songs. This is the last track off their 2020 record called Self My Man. And this one, my mom loves this song. So mom, this one's for you if you're watching. This one's called Easy Street. So this next one is another original of mine. You probably heard me play this a lot, tell the story a lot. The very concise version of the story is that when I was younger, I used to want to live in New York City. Those dreams were dashed when I realized there's lots of people that live there, and my social anxiety said, no way, no how, you can only visit, but you cannot live there. Because anxiety's, you know, fun. So I kind of wrote the song about it, and, you know, what you would miss having in a smaller town versus somewhere like New York City. And just kind of, like, the second verse is mostly, like, my experiences growing up, like, going out to my grandparents' house and driving through all of that. So without further ado, this one is an original. It's called Homesick. Homesick.
The summer night seems to last a little longer. Bright stars shine above your head. But it's hard to see those stars in New York City, the city that never sleeps. Just about everybody. Now you barely know your neighbor's name. And instead of seeing fireflies, well, all you see are headlights. It's these small things you never thought you'd miss. But the more you are bright and tall and lean. It's a familiar visual, but those drives, you put your headphones on and watch the time slip away. And all you wanna do is be a kid again. You'll see small things you never thought you would miss. But the more you think, you're gonna miss it.
So, there's a backstory to this song. Hold on. This song and this band are very important to me. This is a band. They're relatively new. They just had a single come out last Tuesday. They're called The Knee-Highs. They're a Chicago-based band. And if you watch my Instagram story from Monday, you will see that I kind of had, like, a really big fangirl moment. So, I covered their song for my, like, weekly YouTube thing where I post a cover video every week. Which I have dubbed New Music Monday, so that's coming out tomorrow, so look out for that. But last week, I did Darlin Darlin by the Knee-Highs, and I, like, posted on my story that it was up and tagged them, and they reposted my video, so I was, like, freaking out on the inside. I was so excited that, like, oh my gosh, my favorite band actually watched my cover of their song, which is incredible. And then, like, oh my gosh, it was so amazing, you guys, and I just had this, like, freak-out moment. And then a couple days ago, they posted that they had finally put merch up on their website, and I impulse bought their merch at, like, 10:30 at night because I am, like, obsessed with them. They're so good, and it's almost like this, like, 60s daydream of how amazing this song is, and I love it so much. So anyway, I'll stop rambling about how much I love them right now. So they're so good. Definitely go check them out. Follow them on Instagram and Spotify and all of that stuff, and because they deserve it. They're really four talented, amazing human beings, and I love them very much. So anyway, this is called Darlin' Darlin'. Shut my eyes. So, this next one is by a band called The Wild Reeds. They're kind of like this really amazing three-part harmony band, and they kind of remind me of Crosby, Stills, and Nash. They're like that good. And I caught their Tiny Desk concert on YouTube from 2015 because I was looking for anything to listen to because, you know, you kind of run out of music to listen to when you're stuck in quarantine. But that, you know, that's why we have YouTube and stuff like that. So I heard them sing the song live at Tiny Desk, became obsessed with them, like, have listened to pretty much everything they've done so far. It's all really great. But this one is, like, my absolute favorite that I've heard by them, and this one's called Everything Looks Better in Hindsight.
When you wake up in the morning, are you lonely? To find only the items I'd left by your bedside on the table to your right hand. Little traces are the proof that I exist. You reside with the sweet set stuck above you in the rafters and the books and the records on each side and the books and the records on each side. But I knew I could grow to love him, but his walls came back to us. I was strong in his presence, but he before his past. Now will he ever stop haunting me and let me go? My mind shrivels to memories. When my mind shrivels to memories, and I only remember the sweetest two things. Will I only remember the sweetest things? Keep her wanting. Don't desert now the way that you did me. Cook her breakfast, share your music, tell your secrets. Give you all I can ever plan to leave. Or did you plan to leave? Travel through song and an honest remembrance of you. so strong in his presence, but he led me for his paths. Never stop haunting me and let me go. Never say goodbye to me. I've been on my own. To my left hand, little traces are the proof that you exist.
Nice, huh? Okay, cool beans. Okay, so this next song is a KT Tunstall song. If you don't know who she is, you probably do. Her song called Suddenly I See is in the beginning of The Devil Wears Prada, just for like frame of reference here. So she is such an important musician in my life. She was one of the very first female singer-songwriters that I ever saw perform live, perform her own material, and do it all by herself. You know, she's the Looper Girl. Well, that's not all she does. She does amazing stuff, but you know, Black Horse in the Cherry Tree was like one of the first songs I ever heard by her. And she's just such an influential person. She's so down to earth, so incredibly sweet. And, you know, she's just, I love her so much. And her music is so good. It's all I can, it's just so good. You just have to go listen to it. So this song is a really amazing one. This is off her, I think her fifth studio album called Wax. And yeah, it's amazing. And so this is KT Tunstall's The River.
Something I can touch, I don't want to.
white tea.
Cool.
So, excuse me. Pardon. All righty. So, I want to kind of touch on this for a second. If you've been kind of listening to the artists that play these songs, they're all females this week, and I think that's in part to, you know, we just, as female-presenting people, we need to be supporting each other no matter what, because the struggle is not over, and, you know, all of that stuff. But also, if you saw my post earlier this week, I came out as non-binary, which means I am neither male or female. I am just a human. And that was something that I didn't plan on sharing with people outside of my family and friends that I chose to tell. But I think it's so important, especially nowadays when there's still such a stigma around non-binary people, transgender people, people who aren't your typical labels within the spectrum that is not being straight. And it's just still such a struggle to find people like that. And so it was kind of, for me, a way to not only support those people, but also to, like, say, like, hey, I am a safe space where we can talk about this, because I think it should definitely be an ongoing conversation about your gender identity and what that means to certain people, because, you know, if you don't question it, at least just a little bit, I think, then you kind of, you not shelter yourself, but you almost don't give yourself the allowance to explore another possibility, another way of life, and it makes you kind of appreciate other people's lives a little bit more. So that's just a note from me. So yeah, that was a really big deal, and everybody was super sweet about it, and I totally appreciate it. But hopefully, you know, if you don't like it, you don't understand it, don't hesitate to reach out. I'm willing to answer questions if you have questions, because I'd rather you ask questions and then understand than just hate because you don't understand, because that's where hatred comes from. That's where that prejudice comes from. And so, you know, and if you don't like it, like, that's okay. If I lose followers, that's okay. Like, it doesn't matter. I would rather be true to who I am and create a safe space for other people to be who they are instead of cater to people just because I want to have the follower numbers, because numbers at the end don't matter. So that's just my little note for that. Thank you guys for being so understanding. So yeah, we're going to get back to our regularly scheduled programming now, if I can find the words to say that. So this is a Fleetwood Mac song written by the wonderful, the amazing, the queen of everything, Stevie Nicks. If I had just like a tiny hint of her voice, that would be a-okay by me. But, you know, I like what I have. So anyway, this is I think it's the only Fleetwood Mac song I know. Which I should probably learn more of them, because they're, like, an amazing group. But this is the very first one that I learned when I was first starting to teach myself how to play guitar. And so it's very special to me. So this is Fleetwood Mac's Dreams.
Yeah. Drink of all weariness, take a heartbeat that drives you mad. And the stillness of the memory of what you had. And what you lost. And what you had. Ooh, what you lost. And what you lost. And happens when it's raining.
So, this next one I have for you is an original song of mine, and I wrote this last summer. Yeah, that's right. But it was the summer between my junior and senior year, and I was thinking, like, I gotta prepare for senior year, gotta figure out what I'm gonna do about college, what I want to do with my life, which is be a musician, if you haven't already guessed. And so I was thinking about all of those things, and then what summer kind of means not only to me, but to, I think, the collective of kids and young teenagers, young adults. And of course, you know, like, my senior year kind of got ruined, in a sense, by COVID. But I understand, like, the thing is that I could say, oh, I'm upset about, like, not having a graduation ceremony and not having, you know, time with my friends and my teachers and doing all of the normal things that we would do as seniors in high school. But I think the important thing that I have to keep telling myself, that we maybe should all tell ourselves sometimes when you get down about stuff, is that we're doing this ultimately for the years to come. We're doing this to help other people. And yeah, so just, like, be nice about it, please and thanks.
Yay!
Also wear a mask and wash your hands and keep 6 feet apart and all of that stuff that they tell you to do. Just please do it. Listen to the scientists, not to the people who think they are scientists. So yeah, that's my little PSA. But I hope this song kind of makes you think about what summer means to you and all of that fun stuff. So this one is an original. It's called Summer is for the Children.
Fireflies in mason jars, bright rays of sun, nothing ever going wrong that can't be undone. Weeks that seem to stretch for miles, and nights that come to an end. Weeks that seem to stretch into days. The summers will last forever, but it will pass you away if you forget what it means to be the king who's waiting for its return. Push down all those thoughts and die right in. The summers will last forever, but it will pass you down if you forget what it means to be the kid who's waiting for its return.
Alrighty, so I'm going to leave you with one last song today. Thank you so much for coming to hang out with me. Take time out of your Sunday. Just sit and enjoy some music and all of that fun stuff. It really helps me and to know that you guys are still interested in what I'm doing, which is really great. Let's see. Make sure you don't miss my new Music Monday. New cover's coming out tomorrow morning, which is Monday, which is, everybody hates Mondays. But hopefully, seeing my bald head will make you feel better. Yeah, I'm living my best Sinead O'Connor moment, so, don't at me. anyway. So, when you become an artist, whether that's musician, an actual, artist who draws, paints, tattoos, takes photos, whatever kind of creative art you do, there's always going to be that handful of people who say, have fun with your dreams, but get a real job. Money doesn't come in with art. Being a musician doesn't make money. And to that, I will counter with, I don't care if I'm not going to be rolling in the Benjamins as I get older. I'm still going to make music, whether that's for a giant broad audience, whether that's just for a couple hundred people who actually really care about the art, I'm still going to make music no matter what. So this thing isn't leaving anytime soon. It's never leaving. I will be buried with my guitars. So unless I go in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, that would be pretty dope. But anyway, so, I've had even family members tell me that music isn't a fruitful career. But that's okay. You have your opinions and I have mine. This song that I'm going to play for you now, which is the last one of the set, kind of is about all of that sort of, all of those feelings that you have when you become a musician and all that stuff. So, like I said, thank you so much for taking time to hang out with me on your Sunday. Hope the week treats you well, and I will leave you with one final song, and this one's called The Only Path for Me. Thank you. buddy. So that is all I have for you this afternoon. Thank you so much for taking time out of your day to come hang out with me. Yeah, make sure you tune into my YouTube channel tomorrow. That video will go up. I can't tell you what it is. You're going to have to wait and watch. But anyway, thank you so, so much for hanging out with me today. Hope your week treats you well. Treat yourself kind. Treat others kind. Wash your hands. Wear a mask. And remember, Black Lives Matter. Bye, guys.